everyone, this is MJ with MinIO, and welcome back to the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. In this video, we're going to walk through the labs on deploying a MinIO tenant using the Helm charts. Before we get started actually deploying a tenant with Helm, I want to talk about why we need tenants in the first place. So a native Linux or YAML MinIO deployment on top of Kubernetes is a single tenant of MinIO that shares the same storage, configuration, access credentials, and other settings. So that is one tenant. And while you can kind of divide that up where you're giving different groups access to different buckets and locking those buckets down to certain users, it's still going to share things like these same identity and access management credentials. It's going to share all the same storage. And it's really hard to continue to carve that up at an enterprise level. So the concept of tenants in the MinIO operator allows for you to build out multiple independent MinIO deployments on a single Kubernetes cluster and manage them all independently. That way, each tenant will have its own storage, its own configuration, its own access credentials and other settings. And that really allows for you as an organization to either carve that up inside your organization so that each group that you're working with inside your org has their own storage and their own configurations for how they log into the system. Or if you're presenting this outside of your organization, then you could present each tenant as a different customer who's leveraging your infrastructure to be able to use object storage on your system. So that's sort of the overall reason of why we need to use tenants here and why tenants are important. It really gives you independent units of complete installs of MinIO with a single management point using the operator. With that, let's jump into actually deploying a MinIO tenant with Helm. Just as a quick reminder, in the last part of this series, we actually deployed the MinIO operator itself and accessed the operator console. And if we refresh this screen, you can see here that I don't have any tenants added right now. Now, I could go through and create a tenant using the operator console, and we will actually do that in a later video in the series. But for now, we're actually going to deploy a tenant using the Helm chart. So here we are in the terminal on our server, and we're going to go ahead and first thing we're going to do is download the gzipped file for the particular tenant that we want it to be able to deploy. So in this case, we're going to deploy a tenant version 5.0.6, which matches our operator version. And we're just going to run this curl command minus O. Links in the description to this, as well as the documentation for deploying this on your own. So now we've downloaded this onto our system. And the next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to unzip that file that we just downloaded, or untar rather. So we will run this tar minus zxf tenant-5.0.6 command, and that will unzip that into the tenant directory. So if we do an ls here, you can see that there's a tenant directory now. Next thing we need to do is we need to copy the tenant.values file. So if we go into the tenant folder and look in there, there's a values.yaml file right here. And what we will do is we will copy that to tenant one custom values, and then we'll go ahead and make some changes to that. So first thing I'm going to do is copy that in tenant values.yaml to tenant one custom values. And we're also going to use nano to edit that. So here we are in this file. And what we will do is we will go ahead and update this specifically for a tenant called tenant one. So we will call that tenant one environmental variables. We will provide the access key as MinIO tenant one, and we will make the secret key as MinIO 12345. The name of the tenant will be tenant one. And then remember, as I talked about in the slides, you need to update the configuration that this is going to use to match what you called the secret up here. So in this case, this needs to be called tenant one env configuration. The next thing you'll need to do is customize the number of servers that you want. Now we're running single node here, so we're going to keep this very small. So we're going to say we're going to run one tenant server or pod. We're also only going to have one volume in here as well. Now that's not highly available and you will get warnings about that, but this is just for demonstration's sake. We will make this 50 gigs. And on the system that we are running, you will need to know that your storage class type. In this case, I am running DirectPV, so mine is DirectPV-min-io. So that's where the actual data that's uploaded to the tenant console will be stored. And that's all we really need to edit here. Now, as I said before, there's lots of other options here. So get familiar with this and customize this to your needs. So we'll go ahead and exit out of this. And now we can actually go ahead and deploy our tenant. So if we do a kubectl get pods minus a, we can see that there's some basic stuff installed here, and there's the MinIO operator, but there's nothing for a MinIO tenant. So with this next command, we will be able to see that actually get deployed. So we'll go ahead and run this Helm command. It's Helm install. The namespace is tenant one, and we're telling it to create that namespace if it doesn't exist already. The deployment for Helm is just going to be called tenant one. We're referencing that tenant configuration TGZ file that we downloaded. We're also referencing that values file that we just created and customized. And now we've gone ahead and deployed that. You can see that the status is deployed and that it gives you some additional information about this system. So we won't be able to access it using this. That's just not going to work. But we could do the port forwarding, but we're going to do a node port to access this. But first, let's make sure this is up and running. So we'll do kubectl get all minus n. So that means all resources, and then the n is namespace, and we'll say tenant one. And we can see that the tenant pool is running, that there are a number of services created, and that there is a stateful set for this as well that's assigned. Great. So the next thing we need to do is we need to take that tenant one console that we saw there and actually copy that out. So this is going to be a kubectl get service tenant one console in the namespace tenant one. And we're going to output that as YAML and pipe that out into a file called tenant one-service.yaml. So now that file exists and we need to go in and edit that. So this was the output from an existing service. So we don't have to update a lot of these things, but we do want to update a few things. We want to update the name. And this is not just the console. This is the tenant one node port console because we're actually making this a node port service. The namespace stays the same. So you will need to delete these lines for cluster IPs because this is the cluster IP for the service that we copied. And so there will be essentially a collision because it'll be trying to use the same IP address as something that already exists, which we don't want. So we'll say control K in nano to actually remove those. And then what we also need to do is come down here and update the type. The type will be node port instead of cluster IP. So that should be all there is to that. Note that this is the HTTPS console. So we actually will need to access this using HTTPS, and it will be a self-signed cert because we haven't done TLS yet, but that should work just fine. So let's go ahead and save this file, and now we will apply that file that we just modified. So we can see that that is created now, and we can run this command, link in the description, or rather command in the description here, to get the ports that were assigned. So when I run this for the tenant node port console service, you can see that this is the node port identification right here, and you can see that it's assigned 31795. So if we go to the IP address colon port of node port, we should reach our tenant console. So let's go and see if that is indeed the case. All right, so this is what I was talking about. You are going to get basically a warning saying that this is a self-signed cert, but you can proceed. And here we are at the tenant console. So let's go ahead and log in. MinIO tenant one, just as we created in our Helm chart. And MinIO 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And look at that. We are into our new tenant. And remember before I showed you the operator page, if I come back here and refresh, you can now see that there is a tenant. Even though we deployed this via Helm, the operator UI still recognizes that there's a new tenant deployed and actually shows you information about that tenant in the operator console as well. So now we should be able to upload and download things from here. Let's go ahead and create a bucket. Test one. And we can come to the object browser and upload a new file if we wanted to. Let's upload a 10 meg file. Looks good. And we should be able to go in here and see information about this. Yep, everything looks good. And so let's see also if we can download this file. Yep, was able to download that just fine. So everything looks good. Looks like our tenant is functioning as expected, and we should be good to go. So that is all there is to deploying a basic tenant using Helm. Hope you learned something, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.